Hello, everybody. My name is Terrence Thornhill, and welcome to the new NJSO Youth Orchestra's Winter Showcase. Thank you to M&T Bank, our 30th anniversary season sponsor. Today's showcase will feature students in training ensemble, string ensemble, chamber orchestra, and academy orchestra. I think you'll be impressed and inspired by the creativity, dedication, and perseverance of our students, coaches, and teaching artists. One of the features of our virtual program this year is a series of electives for chamber and academy orchestras. Students get to choose from a variety of topics and specialties taught by our coaches. Here's a look behind the scenes of some of our winter session electives.
There's a lot to talk about in Irish traditional. I have a few tin whistles here. I have tin whistles here that are $300-$400. I have others that are $4 or $5 right in my hand. Mute yourselves for now and play along. Okay.
When you think about Brazil, what's the first thing that comes in mind for you?
Rainforest.
Yeah, so rainforest. How about some rhythms? Have you guys heard any things related to Brazil that... I mean, Luke was onto something. He said Bossa Nova. Yeah, Bossa Nova. We're actually going to talk about Bossa Nova today. So it's a pretty great style that originated in the 1950s in Rio de Janeiro.
I decided that I'm going to talk about some of my African instruments and their connection with Brazilian instruments. Rica. This is an old Brazilian song.
Actually, when you play well, make you happy, isn't it? Absolutely. Yeah, from the string. It works for slow speed and medium speed. It doesn't work for the fast speed, is it true? It doesn't work. If you do this, the fast you can do is this. This is like a bouncer ball, basketball. Can do very fast, slow down, very loud, slow down, soft, soft, so soft, so even you cannot believe. And I'm so relaxed.
Wow, very cool. The next few videos were put together by teaching artists Do Young Kim, Eugene Park, and Sasha Ono, featuring their training ensemble creative composition groups. You will also see some of our academy mentors who are student volunteers from chamber and academy orchestras.
Hello, welcome to Cello Group 2 Winter Showcase. My name is Miss Do Young Kim. We are missing a few students, unfortunately, but today Orchid and Aristotle are going to share their own creative compositions in G major scale, with a different rhythm and order and pattern and so on. Plus, Aristotle is going to share his own creative compositions based on Amazing Grace. Hope you enjoy.
Hello, my name is Orchid Riles.
Thank
Aristotle Arch.
For listening, and then we will looking forward to meeting you for the next spring showcase. Thank you so much.
My name is Zaya Pickering. Welcome to Miss Park's class, in which we all made our own composition in deep scale and made this beautiful piece. I hope you enjoy it.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Jasmine. This is Miss Park's class. This is our creating compositions class where we make our own compositions and then combine everyone's to make a masterpiece. We compose our composition in B major.
Thank you.
Wow, such fantastic stuff for Miss Do Young's class, Miss Park's class, and Miss Sasha's class. Congratulations. Now up next, the string ensemble is led by NJSO's violinist Naomi Youngstein, assisted by violin coach Lucy Corwin and cello coach Fran Rowell. One section of violins has been working on music from Handel's Water Music. This next video shows the creative way they have put the piece together over Zoom.
This is Victoria, and Victoria is going to play the beginning of the air from the Water Music. This is Anna, and Anna is going to be playing the second half of the air from the Water Music. This is Ella, and she will be playing the bourré from the Water Music.
My name is Kelsey, and I'll be playing bourré from the Water Music from letter A to letter B.
This is Kim. She's going to be playing the bourré from the Water Music from the pickup to letter B to the end.
Wow, the SE violins are sounding great. The cello coach, Fran Rao, also teaches a semi-private studio with students from both training ensemble and string ensemble. Fran has put together a video compilation of some of their work this winter.
I'm Fran Rao, and I've been working this semester with the cellists of the string ensemble and training ensemble. We did a project learning melodic material from Pachelbel's Canon in D. We've been working very hard on our general cello skills as well as our counting and rhythm this semester. What you're about to hear is captured from our lesson this past week. We had a click track of the bass line for people to practice with up on YouTube, but very few of us could get to it, and we certainly couldn't play it while we were recording on Zoom. So there are issues, but we did the best we could with counting off and trying to hold a steady tempo. We also had to deal with the issues of latency from the machine, the dropping the signal, and just the general weird sound quality. But if you listen beyond all of that, what you're going to hear is a group of cellists who have learned a piece of music that they all know and can play together the minute we actually can be in each other's company once more. Great work, everyone.
Thank you. Sound of a cello ensemble. Thank you, Ms. Fran Rao, and thank you to the cellists. Now moving on, the chamber orchestra is conducted by NJSO's violist Henry Cao. Their virtual rehearsals include sectional work and creative composition classes. Since the fall, they've been working on a very challenging piece, the Corelli Christmas Concerto, Opus 6, Number 8. Each student recorded their part at home, and here's their virtual performance. You will also hear the continuo, which is recorded by our very own Jose Luis Dominguez and his family.
Thank you.
Wow, what an amazing job. That was fantastic performance. Great job, CEO. Moving on, we have the Academy Orchestra, conducted by Artistic Director Jose Luis Dominguez. We've been spending our time in sectionals and creative composition. The viola section, coached by Martin Anderson, has been learning Bach's Brandenburg Concerto No. 6. Here's their video grid with an assist from Jose Luis on the continuo part. Thank you. beautiful rendition of Brandenburg's Sixth Concerto. Amazing job, violist. Great job. All right, moving on. Zoom limits our ability to play together, but in this next video clip, you will see one of the ways our coaches and students have been making it work. Here's French horn coach Andrea Manosek and one of her students playing an arrangement of Pilgrim's Chorus from Tannhauser. Nice job. Sounds very, very beautiful. Moving on to the Academy Orchestra Cellos. The Academy Orchestra Cellos have been working on the Popper Requiem with their coach, Philo Lee. We heard a preview of this in the fall showcase, and now is the complete piece. Enjoy. Fantastic job, AO Cellist. One of every cellist's favorite pieces, Papa Requiem. Great job to the cellist and great job to their coach, Philo Lee. Now moving on, the final class video was put together by Coach Kathleen Nestor, who works with the Academy Orchestra Flutes. This semester, they've been learning the famous Toreador melody from the opera Carmen. Remember this melody. We'll hear it again at our next showcase when the Academy Orchestra records three movements from the Carmen Suite for Orchestra.
It's very counterintuitive, but I want you to make the eighth notes short and the 16th notes kind of long. What instrument in the orchestra or the band plays a rhythm like this? Ta ta ka 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 ta.
That you snare usually?
Absolutely correct. That's exactly what I was looking for. A snare drum goes ta ta ka ta 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 ka ta 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 ka ta. That's what this rhythm is coming from, because it's a march. You know, the march of the toreadors, the march of the bullfighters coming into the ring and being very proud.
Thank you.
Amazing job, Flutes. That sounded so good. I'm really excited to hear the entire group play that next year with the AO Orchestra. Wow. We are so proud of the amazing work that all of our students have been bringing to life in their creative composition classes. The NJSO recently recorded one of the student compositions, which will premiere as part of the Spring Into Music Gala in May.
I actually made up another melody.
My creative composition group number 2 is a very special group. Before thinking anything about what they wanted their piece to be like, or what kind of a mood, or what kind of a story it would be, this group started off composing musical fragments.
Mr. Dominguez was mentioning, like, you know, we can take even 3 notes or like a simple scale and turn it into an entire piece. I was like, there's no way that can happen. Like, how does that even work?
Natalie started. She played a few notes, and then Ashita wrote some more, like as an answer to that.
When Natalie gave her 3 notes, and you know, she was really creative with it. It wasn't just like 3 quarter notes. It was like, I think like a quarter note, a dotted quarter, and then a half note. It was just 3 notes. But that 3 notes, I mean, took us so far. Behind the camera, I was just continuously playing her 3 notes. It sounded really nice, by the way. And then my fingers just started moving into like, you know, different strings. And I was like, oh my God, this sounds really nice. So I volunteered, I gave my input. And then Samantha came in with her Spanish influence.
I had heard a song in band class, and it was very like Spanishy, and it was very fast paced, but it was stuck in my head. It was really good. And so I raised my hand when Maestro Dominguez asked for any other ideas. And then he took that concept of like a fast paced piece, and then he like converted it into like a slow melody that fit right in between Natalie and Ashita's melody. I've never done any sort of composing or writing music, so having this experience was like a whole new step forward in, like, I guess you could say my music career in a way, because it gave me a whole new set of lenses to look through and to observe how music is actually written. So now whenever I play music, I see music in a whole new way, and in a way it helps me like learn to be a better musician.
I definitely agree, and I think that Maestro Dominguez and Miss Nestor really introduced this like brand new world that I really knew nothing about. And it's really amazing to just be collaborating with, you know, all these people. I mean, like Ashita and Samantha, and they all come from different backgrounds. We're all from different places, but when our minds come together, we really create something so beautiful. And I'm really grateful for this opportunity because I was kind of definitely not in my comfort zone doing this, but I think I've grown a lot and I've learned a lot from this experience.
The blend of different influences, like we have Celine Dion, American influences, and then Spanish influences, and how that came together was to create the beginning of the piece was really beautiful.
Yeah, I definitely agree.
Thank you for that lovely video, dear composers from CO2. Yes, your piece was finished. There's already 3 pieces that are finished. So welcome to our showcase, everybody. And I can't tell you how proud and impressed we all are with how this composition, this creative collective composition effort is turning out to be an incredible list of pieces that we will have new repertoire written by our own students for many seasons to come. I'm currently working on more than 16 pieces that are yet to be finished. In our first showcase, we shared some of the audio of the progress of some of the groups. So today we're going to share some of the progress of the groups that were not present in that first showcase. So let's get started. Our first piece, first audio share is going to be from AO Group 1B. And you will see a manuscript that's by fast handwriting. This is how I receive their music. Sometimes I receive recordings. So what I planned for today, like in the first showcase, is to show you a little bit of a highlight of what you're going to hear and how I based the arrangement and orchestration by following their themes note by note, though sometimes are extended. So this is the progress of group AO1B, and this group is led by coach Greg LaRosa. Let's hear it. Wonderful job, group AO1B. It's very, very good. And I can't tell you how much I've enjoyed performing, playing, and recording every one of your melodies and working on your music. This is a work in progress, and there's much more music from these students to come. And also, they have already named this piece, though it's not finished yet. So the name of the piece you just heard will be completed, of course. It's called Hazy Sunrise Over Snow-Covered Tulips. Thank you for that name. It will really help me continue your orchestrations and the rest of your themes. Wonderful job. Congratulations. Next, we have group from Academy Orchestra, Group 2B. This group is coached by Professor Jimmy Musto. And this is a very special piece because they've been working really hard on different ideas beyond the melodies itself. So I first use what you see there. The first few notes that you see is among the first emails I got with music played by a student. And they went into this amazing journey of finding rhythms they attached to their names, and Professor Jimmy Musso just led them brilliantly into coming up with a very clear texture and instrumentation. So I had just a lot more than just the music and the melody. I also had instructions of how to orchestrate it. So this piece has no violins, for example, it has some just low strings, some percussion, and some brass. And please enjoy. Wonderful suggestions by Professor Jimmy Musto. We have some percussion, very busy percussion there, and some woodwinds. Much more to come for that wonderful piece soon. Okay, moving on. Now we have from Academy Orchestra, composition group number 4. This composition group is coached by Professor Robert Wagner and Professor Philo Lee. So this is the bassoons and the cellos combined. So I think you will notice when you hear the music that is very heavily influenced to the low strings. And that's how they have presented it to me. And of course, I have followed to the letter their instructions of who plays what. And these are amazing themes that came together in a very particular way. And there's also a lot more to come. And not all your themes are here, but it's a work in progress. Enjoy. Amazing music, my dear students. That's amazing music, and so much more to come for all of you watching today. That's just like half of the musical material that that group of students have presented. It's so much more coming. There's so much more. Moving on, we have a group from Chamber Orchestra. This is group CO4. This group is also coached by Professor Kathleen Nestor. So this group is quite special. I wanted to just tell you very quickly what you're going to see here in the manuscript. So they started by using rhythms, kind of depicting how their names sounded. And I took note of that, by the way. I wrote that down. You see down there in the second bottom half of the manuscript. So, and then as they evolved and they continued to go deep into the idea of being creative and coming up with a piece of their own, they found, which is very good also, and a very good advice, they found inspiration on other types of music or pre-existing music. So they came up with this idea of doing something in the style of Pirates of the Caribbean. So by Hans Zimmer, an amazing composer. So the idea is to build a piece based on everything they have sent to me. So for example, the second theme you see there by Veronica, you will not hear that theme because it's going to be in a very fast pace coming later on. We're not there yet, but I did use, and I circled, I know you cannot see it very well, but I circled the first couple of notes, some notes of that theme, and used them in a slow introduction in the style of film music. And then you will hear everything you see in the page is somewhere on this work in progress audio. So please, CO4, enjoy your music. There it is. Good job, everybody. That's the fast-paced section is coming soon. I'm working on it already. So our next group is from Academy Orchestra. This is AO Group 7. This is a combination of the trumpets and the horns led by Professor Anderson and Andrea. So they have been working on, they started with the idea of a kind of a brass symphony, but it has evolved. So you, what you see here in the PDF on the page is the essence of their themes. They have developed it a lot more. And I have to give a big shout out to James, one of the students, because what you see there by James, it's all him. I only orchestrated his music note by note, but he sent harmony and melody and everything. So congratulations to all of the students of the group with their contributions. Julia's theme is amazing and much more to come. I have tons of pages with more music from this group. So this is just a taste. Let's enjoy. Bravo, bravo, it's wonderful music and it's all yours, note by note, congratulations. The last audio file we're sharing with you today is from Academy Orchestra Group 5. This is a group that is a combination of clarinets and double basses, and they are coached by our own very own Professor Andy Lamy. And they have come up with an incredible journey. So there's a lot of students in this group, and you only see the names of the students that I use the examples of the music, because actually we are just done with the first two parts of their music. There's many more, and they decided to base their composition on mythical figures from around the world. And the first piece, the first part of the piece by Madison is La Madre Monte, which is kind of a magic fairy goddess of the Colombian forest. So it's very, very descriptive. It's very deep. It's very beautiful. And it has several little parts in between. And right after that, we have the Hugak by Patrick. The Hugak is something I had to Google. They sent me pictures. It's a mythical animal that, well, you'll see at the end. We're going to show some pictures when the music is finished at the end of everything. So there's many more movements to come. And they have also been very specific in their suggestions for orchestration, even harmony. And the rest is just for you to enjoy. Go ahead.
Thank you.
There it is, La Madre Monte and Hugak. To all of you students, fellow composers, congratulations. You're amazing. You have exceeded all of our expectations. And I want to thank you very, very strongly from the bottom of my heart to all the coaches. All of you are amazing. And you have all led your groups in different ways to just ignite that amazing creativity. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart for all your work and inspiring approach to collectively create together. Terrence, you're up.
Wow, what incredible music. What incredible compositions. The ideas were amazing. Thank you, Jose Luis, for making that music, inspiring that, or putting that music together for us all to be able to hear. It's incredible. So thank you very much. And thank you, families. Thank you all for watching today and supporting our students. And congratulations to our students on a successful winter session. Woohoo! Special thanks to the M&T Bank, our 30th anniversary season sponsor. Thank you to all of our dedicated New Jersey Symphony musicians, teaching artists, artistic leadership, staff, and trustees. If you would like to join us for our studio recital featuring individual student performances, it will begin at 1 p.m. and the link is in the chat. Please save the date for our spring showcase on June 19th. We also are gonna put the roster, all of the names of our musicians, and a link in the chat from today's concert. Thank you for joining us. Signing off from NJSO. Hopefully see you at 1 o'clock. Take care, goodbye.